Good morning, everyone. My name is Aparna Rajesh, and I will be the host for this session. We're all set to begin our paper presentations. Today, research has become a part and parcel of our everyday lives. It's very important for us as media students to know our surveys from our questionnaires and keep up with the incoming research topics and methodologies. Research becomes extremely important as it enables the reader to ensure the reliability and validity of any and all information. And this is why all of us are gathered here to witness this marvelous dissemination of knowledge from all our paper presenters. So without any further ado, I'd like to introduce the chairperson for this panel, Dr. Naresh Rao. Dr. Naresh Rao is currently working as an associate professor in the Department of Media Studies, Christ University. He has a PhD in communication from Bangalore University, from where he also received his MS in communication. Naresh Rao joined the then Christ University, Christ College, as a lecturer in 1993 in the Department of Journalism. His current research includes social media, political communication, branding, media ethics, and films. He has 12 papers to his credit and his two books, one on journalism and other on media laws. Recently, he's finishing a major research project on the role of social media during the 2019 Indian general election and is also working as a section editor for the new media track on a book titled New Populism and Responses in the 21st Century. He is passionate about politics and films and uses blogs to comment on them regularly. We request everyone to put in their questions in the chat box. We will be taking them up at the end of the respective paper presentations. There will also be a feedback form that will be sent during the last 5 minutes for all Christ students for attendance purposes. Please pay attention to the session and take necessary notes that you can fill in the form. Once again, we welcome you, Dr. Naresh, and over to you, sir, to introduce the papers for the day.
Okay, thank you, Aparna. And once again, welcome to this day three of Media Meet 2021. And we are today gathered to hear some of the papers that have been chosen for Media Meet presentation. So we have with us four presenters or four papers, and in some cases we have co-authors. So let me first introduce the first paper. This is by Afroz Yunus Khan, and the title of the paper is Coverage of COVID-19 Crisis, Comparative Study in Media Framing Between Hindi and English Dailies, limited to the Aligarh edition. So I think all of you are familiar with the format for the presentation. So you get 12 minutes for your presentation, and the next 3 minutes will be for any kind of question answers. First, I think, right for any question would be the co-presenter. So anyone else who's part of the presenters, they can ask question, and then we open it up to the audience in general. So we also have three more papers. I just read out the name of the paper presenter and the paper title. So the second paper is by Abbasuddin. It's titled Penning Against the Taliban, a study of women journalists' role in tackling radicalization. And then we have the third paper by Ruchika Lalla and Utkarsh Chaudhary. Does local truly mean authentic? A critical examination of COVID-19 reportage in India. And finally, we have a paper by Dr. Madhusmita and Shubhajit Paul titled Global Media and Popular Geopolitics, a View on the Israel and Palestine Conflict. So let's start with the first paper. This is by Afroz, and over to you. You have 15 minutes, that means 12 minutes to present the paper, and there'll be a warning given or a caution given at the end of 10 minutes so that you can finish it within the 12 minutes given to you. So over to you. You can start.
Requesting participant approves to start.
Just a moment.
Okay.
Respected jury member, organizers, fellow presenters, a very good morning to all of you. My name is Afroz Yunus Khan. I'm a research scholar in the Department of Mass Communication, Aligarh Muslim University. My topic of presentation is coverage of COVID-19 crisis, a comparative study of media framing between Hindi and English dailies. I pursued this research with an aim to determine dominant frames used in the coverage of COVID-19 by print media. Next slide. We all have seen a surge in the coverage of pandemic since the outbreak of novel coronavirus. In fact, we are bombarded with its news through authorized and unauthorized institutions. And for the authentication, we generally turn back to print media. The role of media becomes significant as it has got the power of mitigating and accentuating an issue and shaping the public opinion. Next slide. Media framing. This concept was first championed by Irving Goffman in the year 1974. A frame can best be described as a window through which a story is told. The theory of media framing, it does not direct the people what to think about, but also how to think about it. Next slide. COVID-19 was first declared as the pandemic on 11th March 2020 by WHO. And since then, media is trying their best to keep the audience updated. The best way to combat such pandemic is to know about it, is to be aware about it. And here comes the importance of media in educating the masses about the public health issues. Next slide. My research questions revolved around the determination of major frames used by the print media and to ascertain the similarities and differences in the frames used by English and Hindi media. The last research question asks about the newspaper, the language newspaper, which employed more front page headlines, as it's been believed that more space dedicated to a story reflects higher degree of significance given by the media. Next slide. In the method, the study being quantitative in nature, I have used content analysis as the major tool of the study with deductive approach. The same can be seen in the next slide. Yes, thank you. If we look at the mass media research, the literature speaks out whenever there is analysis of framing is done, content analysis is used widely. Next slide. The time frame for this study is 2 months, that starting from 1st April to 31st May 2021, when the second wave in India intensified. The unit of analysis included all the articles that were related to COVID-19, and the selection of the media, the newspapers, were based on the top readership and circulation in Aligarh. So the selected papers in English were the Times of India and the Hindu, whereas in English, Dainik Jagran and Amar Ujala were selected. Talking about the sampling of articles, so I had selected 2 articles for each day for all the selected newspapers, amounting to 488 stories. The sampling was done judgmentally, where I have chosen the first story preferably on the front page, a headline preferably. And the second story was included from included on the basis of more space dedicated to that story, like more columns given along with the photograph and caption. So such stories were selected for the studies. Now coming to the frames used, see, as the study is deductive in nature, so I have taken predetermined frames from the previous studies. Taking human interest frame, economic consequence, attribution of responsibility, and conflict frame, these four frames were inspired from the study of Semetko and Walkenberg 2000, whereas fear, hope frame, and politicization, these three were taken from the very new work done by Ogbodo et al. In the year 2020. Apart from these seven, I have chosen neutral frame. So altogether, eight frames were chosen. Next slide. Now here are the results. So all the frames, like all the stories, selected articles were read thoroughly, and they were sorted in different frames. So according to that, overall, the maximum frame that were used in the study, it was hope frame. Overall, it was hope frame, and which was followed by the fear frame. If I talk about the newspapers separately, then Amar Ujala and Times of India, both of these papers have used fear frame the most, which was followed by the hope frame. Yes, next slide. The same percentage distribution can be seen in this slide, where all the newspaper, the amount of coverage in the different frames is given here. Yes, next slide. It is the representation of the previous one. Yes, now the classification of the papers language-wise, English and Hindi dailies. So if you look at English paper altogether, again, hope frame dominated here. Similar is the case of Hindi, where again, hope frame was dominated. Now talking about the second top frame. So in English media, it was fear frame, whereas in Hindi, it was politicization frame. Yes, next slide. This is again percentage division of the previous table. Next. Again, this was question four, research question four, where percentage of the new of the COVID news, the space given on the front page. So paper wise, it's given here. In totality, Dainik Jagran topped the list, but overall, when we talk about language paper, so English paper topped here because Amar Ujala has employed only 75% of the headlines on the front page. Yes, next slide. Findings. According to the research question, the first question that asked dominant frame. So as I stated earlier, hope frame dominated, followed by the fear frame. Coming to the second question, similarity. So there were two similarities that were found in the analysis. Hope frame, it was common in both. In fact, in all the newspaper except for two. So hope frame dominated, and the least covered frame was economic consequence in both the languages, English and Hindi both. Yes, next slide. The third question was about the differences between English and Hindi media. So there were two frames found, politicization and neutral, in which both the newspapers were quite different, differ significantly. Then the last one is which language newspaper. Again, it was quite clear in the findings that English newspapers topped the list in the coverage of COVID-19 stories in the front page headlines. Yes, next slide. Here is my conclusion. See, throughout the research, we have seen that hope frame dominated the study. So it can be from this, it can be reflected that media is continuously trying to frame the stories in the optimistic way. So basically, they are trying to cover up the panic state in the minds of the people. So that is the good thing about media. But one thing, because the second dominant frame was fear or scaremongering frame. So here is a suggestive measure for media that they need to be more sensible while framing the stories so that they can reduce the panic state among the people. That's it about my presentation. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you.